my gosh.
Good boy. With his floppy ears and different colored eyes, little Gouda is just as cute as he can be, and he's come a long way since coming into Barks last week. The two-month-old was found nearly dead, emaciated, and hypothermic.
So he was transported immediately to the ER, where he spent a few days getting fluids, getting his body temperature back up.
Gouda is one of three puppies that have come into the shelter recently in need of urgent medical care. Six-month-old Roller Coaster is part of an animal control investigation for neglect.
Almost the same situation as Gouda, extremely thin, so thin that he couldn't maintain his own body temperature. Now he's in a foster home where, for him, he's a little bit older. He actually is eating tiny meals a day, all day, which is why he needs to be in foster and not here in the shelter. He needs to be taken care of pretty much around the clock.
And so does Seattle. She was found on the streets of Baltimore in horrific pain after suffering two broken legs and other injuries, all consistent with being repeatedly hit and kicked. Her first surgery revealed more injuries.
When they went to do the surgery, it turned out to be even more complicated because, unfortunately, they found more areas on her body that had the same injuries that they believed were older because they had already healed over improperly. So she's got a long road ahead of her.
It's medical care made possible through the shelter's Frankie Fund. More than $40,000 was donated when Seattle's story was shared hundreds of times on social media. And while Seattle's case raised a lot of money for the Frankie Fund, each year Bark spends about $1 million in medical care, and so every dollar helps.
We treat anywhere between 800 to 1,200 animals, and those are the serious emergency and or specialized medical cases. And then here in our shelter, we're treating all the rest of the animals, which is about another 10,000 animals a year.
Gouda and Roller Coaster will be adopted just as soon as they're healthy enough, and eventually, so will Seattle.
We're going to make sure that Seattle is never in the hands of somebody who will do anything but love and take care of her from here on out.
Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.